When it happens in Europe or America, it's headline news. But in Turkey, they take it for granted that getting a tank full of petrol will take all day. There are only two kinds of garages here, those closed for lack of petrol, and those under siege by hundreds of motorists, waiting not always patiently in queues often miles long. And if that fails, well, some people have just given up the struggle. And it's not just petrol. There's no point at all in queuing for some things that we regard as basic essentials. The shops are stocked, but it's all local stuff. There's no coffee or sugar or decent cigarettes, or for example, light bulbs, or indeed anything that has to be imported. The problem is that Turkey, quite simply, is broke. 3 years ago, it was booming with one of the highest sustained growth rates in the world. Now, its trade gap is one of those figures so astronomical as to be meaningless to most people. More than £1 billion this year. Inflation is around 70% and rising. Unemployment is 25% and rising. And a combination of being out of work and broke and unable to buy things, even if you do have a few lira in your pocket, has led inevitably to internal strife. More than 600 people have died already this year in factional fighting between various political groups, and the army are on the streets. Nearly a quarter of the country is under martial law, a major blow to a nation that has spent half a century living down its past and earning a reputation of democracy of which it was proud. Now that democracy is threatened by a weak coalition government incapable of tackling the escalating problems. From localized incidents, the violence has been steadily growing. In Adana, for example, 803 people are standing trial, in which over 100 people died. They're not the usual activists who get caught up in such incidents. They include housewives and schoolchildren, professional people and unemployed labourers, and 330 of them face the death penalty if found guilty. Whatever the outcome of the trial, it'll almost certainly be the signal for yet more violence.
Turkey's problem was one most nations of the world suddenly faced in 1973 when the Middle East war created the oil crisis. It's just that Turkey failed miserably to cope with it. While the world was in recession, Turkey turned a blind eye to reality. And when reality caught up, it started borrowing to forestall economic collapse. And now it's sliding rapidly into bankruptcy and political chaos. And although Turkey owes more to Eastern influence than Europe and the West, its problems are of major concern to us, because Turkey is the southeastern cornerstone of NATO. If Turkey collapses, there's a major unpluggable hole in NATO's defences.
It's Turkey's strategic importance that may save her. Standing as she does at the crossroads between Asia and Europe, Turkey is necessary to the Western powers and coveted by the Russians, whose ships must pass through the Bosporus en route from the Black Sea to the Mediterranean and beyond. And so Turkey's allies, out of necessity rather than desire, are preparing to try and bail her out, accepting that they may have left it too late. This is Keith Graves in Istanbul.